the first time, please subscribe our channel and do not forget to press bell icon so that you will get any notification of any future videos which will be uploaded in our channel. So today we are going to share some information about main engine fuel oil high pressure pipes. So today we are going to see what are all the maintenance that we do in electronic engine fuel oil high pressure pipe, because this high pressure pipe is always a double sheeted pipe, and there are a lot of difference between this high pressure pipe and MC engines high pressure pipes. So the maintenance almost will be the same, but only the datas and clearance that we take in MC engines will be little more, and in our ME engines is very simple. So I will let you know how to dismantle a fuel oil high pressure pipe, what are all the checks that we need to do when overhauling a high pressure pipe, and please continue watching the video fully. We'll go inside the video. Okay, so this is our fuel oil high pressure pipe for main engine MAN, ME engines. So first I want to tell what are all the parts, which is parts and tools which is incorporated in overhauling this high pressure pipe. You can see the both the end of high pressure pipes are different. You can see this pipe, that this end will be incorporated in a distribution block, and the other pipe, you can see here, this pipe is incorporated to your fuel oil valves. So you have to be very careful when you are doing maintenance on this fuel oil high pressure pipe, because when you don't do it properly, then it may affect you when you are doing when engine is running, because if the surface is not proper, then during running the fuel oil will start leaking and it will give you again a new problem. So whenever you do the overhauling, please ensure you are doing the job in a correct way and proper way, so that when you install it in the main engine, so during running it won't give any problem. So now this is your milling tool. This is your milling tool, and this is also a milling tool for your high pressure pipe ends for this area. Okay, so these are the three tools that we use for doing maintenance for our high pressure pipe and the pipe distribution block. Okay, so now we will see how to open, dismantle this high pressure pipe. So I will open from the, I'll open one side. And this is also your milling tool, and this will be used in your fuel oil distribution blocks. So this pipe, one end will be fitting on the distribution block, and for that distribution block maintenance we will use this milling tool, and this milling tool will be using for doing maintenance on our fuel oil high pressure pipe. So these are all the special tools that we use to do maintenance work on our fuel oil high pressure pipes. Now we will see how to dismantle the pipe, and always ensure you are securing this milling tool safely. Usually this milling tool will come with a cover in a box, sponge box. Keep it safely in that box only, because if it get dropped, this sharp edge will get damaged. You can see the milling edge, this will be damaged if you drop somewhere. So always keep this tool safely and securely. Okay, so now I will show you how to dismantle a high pressure pipe. This high pressure pipe is for MAN engines, which is electronic type. So so
The difference between this man engine high pressure pipe and normal MC engine high pressure pipe is this man engine's electronic engine's high pressure pipe will be coming from the fuel distributor block. See, that one I will show you, I will open it and show you later. So from the distributor block it connects to your fuel injector. But in your MC engines, the fuel high pressure pipe will be connected from your fuel pump to your injectors. So the maintenance will be similar, but only some data will differ when you are doing the maintenance work for fuel oil high pressure pipe. Okay, so whenever you open your high pressure pipe, you need to ensure this area should be very clean and it should not have any scratches, any damages, any cracks or something, because this is the facing area where it connects directly to your distributor block or your fuel oil injectors. So I'll open this now. So first thing you need to do is you have to open the union nut. So when you open the union nut, you can see a cone over here. This cone will be locking your you can see here, this cone is your locking arrangement for this cane. So when you tighten this will be against with your union nut and it will hold against your nipples. So now I'm going to remove this. See, if you turn this, it won't come. So when I remove it, it will come out. So I remove this cone. Okay, I remove this cone. You just need to push it backside. So okay, so it is out. So you remove the union nut and there will be two sleeves that should be pushed upside. So now we have to hold this in a vise and open the second union nut. So always when you are holding your high pressure pipe, ensure you have a soft packing in the vise so that it don't damage your fuel oil high pressure pipe. So now I need to open this union nut. So whenever you are opening it, you be careful because you should not damage your threads. You use proper spanner when you are using to open your union nuts. If you are using the wrong size spanner, you may damage your thread head. Okay, I open now. So I open first union nut and your cone bushing, and one more cone bushing, second union nut, and there will be one more slip can over the. So now you need to open your O-rings housing. Yeah, you can see there is a O-ring over here. So this is the housing for your O-ring. Suppose if you find any leakage in your fuel oil high pressure pipe, most probably your O-ring must have gone damaged. So whenever you do your overhaul of your high pressure pipe, you have to remove it and renew it. So this is already removed. So now we have to take out from the vise and we have to start removing it. Okay, so you can see here there is a lock pin over here. This is your lock pin. So you need to remove the lock pin. This is your lock pin. And so now you need to open your lock ring. So when you open it, you can take out the nipple outside. So I'll open this now. So that's all. I open this. So one, this is your sealing part, and you can now remove your nipple. And this you cannot able to, this is your bushing, so this you cannot able to remove. And now then you start removing your the unit nut, and we remove the o-ring housing. You can see two o-rings over here, there would be two o-rings, one will be inside your housing, one will be in top of your housing. Okay, and then open the opened one side of our fuel oil high pressure pipe. So in this, what you have to see is whether there is any damage in your threads. In all the thread size you can see there is no damage. So whenever you open it, always do a buffing of your threads. So this one is clean, and this is also clean. Okay, I will do a buffing of this. Always use safety shield when you are doing buffing. Okay. Threads are clean now. Okay, you can see it's clean. Now I am going to assemble this. Okay, so we remove the o-ring and we remove the seal ring also. So we remove both. So it is better whenever you overhaul your high pressure pipe, it is better to change the o-ring and seal rings. So that because this high pressure pipe mostly we do once in 4000 hours. So it is better to change your o-rings whenever you do the overhaul of your high pressure pipe. And o-ring area should be, see, you can see a lot of carbons over here. You can see carbons. So all these carbons you have to remove it. Just take any sharp welding rod or something, just remove it, and so it will be easy and it will be good when you are putting a new o-rings. Okay. So So now we are done with the cleaning of your o-ring bushing, o-ring housing. Okay, so now we will change the o-ring also. So now we are going to renew the o-rings. So these are all the two old o-ring. I am going to renew with the new o-ring. So okay, so I'll put some moly coat. This moly coat will prevent any seizing, and because this high pressure pipe is dealing with very high temperatures, so we have to put a layer of anti-seizure. Okay, so now we changed both the o-rings and the seal ring. One o-ring and one seal ring changed already. So so since this fuel oil high pressure pipe is clean, no need to do buffing and all. You can see there is no carbon, no deposit, nothing. It is very clean. And one more thing, in the beginning I told you the fuel oil high pressure pipe is a double sheet pipe. That means we will be having a two pipe. So you can see this is the top pipe and this is the inner pipe. So if there is any leakage in this pipe, it don't directly spray outside. So it is for a safety thing, because since this high pressure pipe always deals with very high pressure fuel oil, for safety purpose this fuel oil high pressure pipe will be always double sheet. So whenever there is any leakages in the pipe, there is a connection which goes to the leak off line, so we can identify the pipe is leaking. So we can do the necessary action. So this is how you can make it out. So this is the top pipe and this is the inside pipe. So this is the reason why they say fuel oil high pressure pipe is always a double sheeted pipe. So okay, so again if we do the reverse way, whenever you do the boxing up, so I put back the union nut, I put back the cone, I put back our second cone. Okay, so these three are in place, and third will be our union nut. So again, this union nut, you check for your thread should be clean. So I just clean it with a sharp edge. If there is any thing in your threads, it will come up. Always ensure your threads are clean. There is no dirt, no carbon, nothing in your thread area. So that whenever you are doing maintenance, you have to ensure your union nut threads are clean, free of any kind of deposits. Whenever you are using your union nuts or any holes, you have to give a coat of anti-seizure or grease, depend upon where you are using. So I use moly coat over here and both the side and inside also. Okay, I put back it. I ensure it is tightening properly, so it is okay. Now next will be our seal ring housing. So again same way, seal ring housing in place. Next our nipple. So again put some Mollycoat over here. Put it in place. Yeah. So check. Since it is a new seal ring, yeah, that's all. And then finally will be your locking ring. Locking ring, okay, so we are done with our overhauling of our high pressure pipe. Next thing is we are done with inspection and overhauling of our entire union nut, nipples, changing of O-ring and everything. Next, how do we do the lapping of your mating surface? That is very important. So if you find any scratch mark or anything, you have to do milling for the particular pipes. So you can see a gap over here. This is the point maximum it can go. You can see a two layer. So I will do. Okay, this is the tool for doing the milling of fuel oil high pressure pipe. You can see here. See, this is your milling tool. So whenever you do the milling, always ensure the tool is clean and your milling surface is clean. When you do milling, you just need to apply some lube oil. So I clean the milling tool first. While doing the milling operation, you should not put any kind of grinding paste. You just only need to put some lube oil, and that's all. You have to do that. So again, so we'll all pipe properly. Okay, so this is our tool. So you have to fix the tool in such a way this milling should properly sit over your surface. So I will just blow some air. This surface is clean. I just want to show you how we have to use the tool for doing the milling operation. So you just clean the surface, put some oil over here. So put some oil. Surface, and that's all. So you need to fix it up. So you can see, this tool, it got a different thread over here which can accommodate here. So I have to tighten it. Okay, this tool I have tightened, and now I have to tighten the milling tool. So when I tighten, I can feel whether it is touching the cone or not. So yeah, it's already touched. So what I need to do is you can either use a spanner or you can use a handle for it. So this is how you have to fix your tool, and during your milling operation you just need to put some lube oil so that any heat will be removed. And whenever you do the milling, always do in one side, you cannot do in the opposite side, do it in one side, so it will be properly done. So I'm going to remove it. Okay, so we removed the tool and this is your surface. Okay, now we overhauled the fuel oil high pressure pipe one side. The same way we have to overhaul the other side also. So this side of your high pressure pipe will be sitting on, fitted on your fuel oil block. This is your fuel oil distributor block. So this pipe will be fitted over here. So will be here, the other end will be it will be like this one. So one end will be your fuel belt, the other end will be your distributor block. This is how the fuel oil high pressure pipe fit on our electronic engine. So we are done with our overhauling of fuel oil high pressure pipe. And one thing you have to be very careful is whenever you are securing this pipe, you have to ensure your threads are being properly secured. If not, it will hit somewhere and it may get damaged. So you should be very careful when you are securing your fuel oil high pressure pipe in place. Okay, thanks for watching. So today I told you how to do the assembling and pressure testing of fuel valve of main engine. I believe you would have got some information about how to perform all this operation. So please watch the video completely, and if you like this video, please like, share, and don't forget to subscribe. If you have any comment, even it is not okay comment, please put it in our comment page so that we will try to develop in future. Thanks for watching.